Oh no! I'm a failure! Hey guys, James of the New Squad 2 here, and today we're doing a 1.12 snapshot of Minecraft, and it's the latest snapshot, so don't you worry. A lot of stuff has been added. I'm finally doing this, and hopefully a gameplay video will come out, and I'll be able to, like, upload a vlog or something. I don't know. It's hard for me to figure out what I want to do because I want to do so much. Anyway, look at this house. Just a villager house with some trapdoors as blinds. A chest filled with all the new styled, colored, vibrant wool. And a crafting table. You weren't supposed to see that yet. Anyway, this is a color bed. It's the blue one. I made it blue because, my bed is blue, and yeah. Also, the cool thing about it is, like, I was watching, like, how I first learned that this snapshot was out was I came across a video that said colored beds in Minecraft 1.12. snapshot, and I'm like, oh my god, it's finally here. Now I can do a video on the beds, because god, we needed more colored stuff. And I noticed, hey, that bed is three-dimensional, so I hopped into the game and it's like, holy crap, it's no longer just a broken 2D thing. Now the only problem with saying that is, well, there's always a chance that Mojang will end up, making this be a temporary thing for snapshots and then bring it back to 2D for the final game, but Mojang, don't do that. Don't bring it back to 2D. Mojang, keep it at 3D. It's beautiful that way. Also, it's actually the less thing that kind of bugs the thing. Because, like, that's an entity now. The beds are entities. And the doors are still blocks, so they had to, like, remove the 3D texture, which sucks. But here's, a giant set that I constructed. Here we got the new saturated, colored, very actually bright and colored full carpets. Revamped. I don't think the texture changed. It's just it looks slightly different because of, like, the, color being brighter. So, yeah. And then you got the beds. Still very colorful, but, like, the bottom row kind of looks a bit like more of the older colors, or is that just me? Anyway, you got the original bed, which is now known as Red Bed, and it's a 3D icon in your inventory. And, oh, damn you, Knight! Well, we're gonna have to be back. Oh my god. Oh, by the way, I just noticed something. If you sleep in your bed, this is a funny glitch. If you sleep in your bed, you'll start walking, laying down in place. I wonder what it looks like in this. Nope, it doesn't show it. Anyway, as I was saying, there's now a color for each bed, and it looks really good. My favorite is the blue one. Well, my favorite is the green one because that's my favorite color, but I really like the blue one because now I can have my bed in Minecraft. Anyway, the white one could be used for the map of A Link to the Past that I'm working on, and hopefully I could get some more people to work on it so that way they can help me build out the land, then the grass, and I could work on the buildings a bit more, and Hyrule Castle. Anyway, you got how the new wool looks. Well, how the wool looks with its new colors. Like, it kind of looks like as if they just painted on, like, added a layer and just color-coded a filter over the original color. The glass, the stained glass and glass, I can't really tell a difference, so I'm not really sure. I'm not sure if it changed or not. I don't know if someone could point that out, but yeah. Also, here are the new concrete powders. They look cool. If only we could, like, get dyeable sand, like, if only we could, like, dye sand to be like this, then it would add for more color variety. Also, I noticed that the black one has kind of a different texture from the rest of these, and some colors have, like, a slight difference in the texture, which is kind of neat. Now, people said there's only a texture in- Now, these are the concrete blocks. Somebody said that there's only a texture in the, black one. Which they would be wrong. Like, yes, there is a texture that you can see in the black one, but that's because it's more noticeable. There's actually the same texture can be found in every single block. It's just harder to see because of its color, and you gotta look really closely on most blocks. Anyway, this is the stained clay, which has now been renamed to terracotta. Yeah. It just says terracotta on it. Yeah, for some reason they renamed it terracotta. Because of the stained terracotta. But you can also see how different the colors are from back then to now. Also, it makes you wonder, why is it brown? And I've always wondered that, but then I remembered, oh yeah, the original hardened stained clay. Excuse me. The original terracotta, if I can find it, the original terracotta is a light brownish color. So, yeah. And this is... What was that? Okay, anyway. This is the stained, this is the glazed terracotta. Many people don't like these blocks, but it's like, and they're like, oh yeah, I hate Minecraft now, I'm gonna quit it because of these blocks. And it's like, you don't have to hate or quit a game just because of the color, just because of a new block. All you have to do is just decide to not use the block, it's that simple. But yeah, I find some of these to be cool. Like, I wouldn't use them in a building sense. Well, I mean, I could use some of them, but I don't really have much of a good idea for it. And also, another thing on the terracotta, let me quickly do this. The terracotta, the glazed terracotta, I mean, apparently, they can't stick to slime blocks. I never knew that they could stick to slime blocks in the first place. But, yeah, let's test it. Oh, first. The slime blocks rock in a cool new texture that nobody has ever decided to, like, point out before. Anyway, if we flick this lever, as you can see, these blocks have been pushed like how they're supposed to. And this gets pushed up, and all the blocks move up with it. But there's a weird thing. This was on a one block thing above these two. And now it's on two blocks higher. And yeah, it just, these didn't move. But this one did move. And yeah, I get it. It's on top of the slime, so it would obviously move. But watch what happens when I flick the lever again. This goes back, but even a sticky piston doesn't pull this back. But this one, which was like two blocks high in the air, should have stayed like right here. But instead, it goes back with the slime block. I think that might be a glitch, but yeah. I forgot to mention, but the beds, they're bouncy now. They bounce you up like slime, so, yeah. I'll get to that. Now, when you jump from, like, this high, let's see how many hearts. Oops, wrong game mode, but hold on. You know what, I'm gonna jump off of the high wall. I'll get to the two blocks a bit more. I'll get to the higher blocks a bit more. This is my first time doing a snapshot, so I'm a little unorganized. I might get a little better. at this, hopefully. Anyway, alright. Okay, so if you fall from this massive amount high, you'll take 2.5 hearts of damage, which is actually quite good. Now I just gotta quickly heal myself. Alright, let's see how much damage a slime block would do to us if we fall from the same height. The answer is none. How come... These things are easy to, like, just compare to, because, like, one takes damage, one doesn't. Anyway, but yeah, another thing about the beds is that if you have a white bed, now, I got some stuff for this. Ah, jeez, crap. If you have a white bed... Ah, jeez, I'm missing a color. The thing about the white... Okay, so the thing about the white bed is that if you, place it down or place it in a crafting table... Jesus Christ. If you place it down or place it in a crafting table, you can dye it by taking a dye. Huh? Wait, this doesn't work anymore? Hold on. Destroy the tree? What? Anyway, so if you take a white bed, put it in a crafting table, you can dye it by putting a dye right next to it. So now we got a green bed. We do the same thing, now we got a purple bed. And again, light gray. And again, orange bed. And yeah, now we just have some of these amazing... Now we just have some of these amazing new colors from just a white bed. So yeah, there might be a lot of white sheep around just for that occasion. Okay. Now, the concrete powder blocks, they look and sound and do stuff just like sand. And essentially, if you get it wet or put it in water, then it will turn into concrete. See? Yeah, it falls down like sand. It just makes people want, like, sand, but in dyeable form. Oh, oops. Okay, that was a bit of a glitch. Now when the concrete powder is put into water, you can mine it and get gray concrete. And also, you can do a lot of stuff with the concrete block. You can take the black one, form it into sort of a little road sort of thing. See that? What a beautiful road. But yeah, nothing has really changed much about the terracotta except for a couple of textures. Like, there used to be lines for the arrows. Also, the terracotta, they're like directional blocks, so you can place them however you want. You can place them backwards, or you could place them forward. And yeah, it can lead to some cool designs. Anyway, yeah. Now, the shulker boxes, they also got a color change to match up with the wool. The purple one, I think it could have stayed matching with the ender brick. I mean, with the purple blocks. Because, like, they no longer blend in, but hey, it was kind of a neat change. Now, these banners, They also got a color change, and yeah. So, like, that way now you can just take a... So that way it means your shields also have a bit of a change, too. So, let's see here. If I can find a shield. Jesus Christ. Okay. Shield. And yeah. See that? New color goodness. Like, now it's just a nice blue. And yeah. Oops. Also, I just want to mention something. For the concrete block, you can actually use them instead of stained clay or other blocks for materials. So yeah, if we head to this little entrance diorama, you might already know what it is. It's Hyrule Castle's outside entrance. I did this so that way I could test to see what it looked like if I put it in the map of a link to the past, and if I actually used it, and I might test out the slime feature, but like, yeah. Anyway, so yeah, I built the entrance part for Hyrule Castle using the stained clay, concrete blocks. So for the drawbridge or the giant door, it uses black concrete for the black line of metal that strands across it in the game, and just use the lighter wood. So that's a bit of use for that. And those shiny green bits on the front of the castle that no one could recreate because it was hard to do it, and they had to use emerald. Now you can use the lime concrete block because it's kind of like a neater version of the emerald block. It's like a brighter color, and it won't have the lines like this. Yeah, it just doesn't look that great. But when you have the concrete block, it actually looks fantastic, in my opinion. And even the blue part that's been hard to match in the game. People used wool or stained clay, but now we can use cyan terracotta because it actually matches the color. Also because this block is actually a quite lovely shade of blue. And also, when you move it like in a certain way, it kind of blends in with the block, so that's kind of a bit odd. But yeah. And, like, you can just use these blocks with many other blocks. Like, you can use it with the end brick and stone brick of, from the end. Some sandstone stairs. And end stone. Oh, by the way, the reason why I chose those blocks for, the Hyrule Castle is because they were close, and also because, also the end stone brick captures the brickiness from, a Link Between Worlds, but it also has the peach white color tone it has in a Link to the Past. Anyway, back to the concrete powder. This thing can't actually change from rain. Hold on. Weather tab. Rain. Rain. Thank you. But yeah, when you do weather tab rain, for some reason it won't change no matter how much water is hitting it. But that's kind of odd, but also kind of neat, which means now, as long as you don't put that block right next to Bill, right next to pools of water, you can have, like, a neat little mountainside where it has some brown concrete. And not have it ruin the color scheme of it by turning into concrete itself. So Mojang, even though this is a slight bug, this is a cool bug that you gotta keep in. Or make it be the actual coding of the game, because that way builders can use this for a mountain tops for, or for maps, for, like, cool advantages as long as it's not by the water. Or, like, as long as it's not by, like, the ocean, lakes, or stuff. So, it would be neat if it's not affected by rain. But, yeah. That's basically it for this guy of what I can think of. But, yeah, if they do change it, then, we really need some colored sand. Anyway. But yeah, I already showed you this, and yeah. Again, I'm not very organized, but I'm going to show you the next thing, which is the sheep. Oh, look how noisy it is. Anyway, you got all 16 colors. The white one looks kind of a little bit gray to me. I don't know why. Oh wait, now it's looking a bit more white, but yeah. One thing I hope Mojang will do next is, make the color wool be the same color as their face, like in the Pocket Edition. Maybe they'll do that at some point, because they got new colors. And god, these colors look kinda neat. Hold on, I wonder what would happen, excuse me. What would happen if we named it Jeb? There we go! Oh, it uses all the new colors, which is cool. Now that's a sheep that people would want to see. Hold on. Now that's a sheep that people would like to see in the snapshot. Jesus. Alright, sorry about that. Anyway, let's move on to the new animal pets that you can have. Since, you can no longer have bunnies as pets, they also added in the first flying mob and decided to be like, you know what, let's make this a pet. Anyway, when you tame a bird, you can make it sit down, and when you get it to, fly... Wait, what the heck? Oh, wait, so that's how you get it to go on your shoulder. Okay, so... basically, you unsit them. I mean, basically, when they're standing up, you can walk up to them. And, yeah. Now, they're on your shoulder. You can run. You can now run with them, so they won't fall off. But if you jump, then they'll fall off, which kind of sucks. Come here, little guy. Eh. Come on. Come on. Come on, buddy. Come on. Buddy. Sit down. Buddy. Alright. Alright, there we go. Now, here's a cool thing. If you place a record in, they'll... Where is it? Alright. If you place a record in, they'll do the disco. Ah, oh, jeez, I wrote the jukebox. Anyway, yeah. That's enough of the birds, because there's not really much on them. Aside from what we know so far. Who knows, maybe there will be more birds in the future. Like, the bird from the first ever 1.8 mod. That would be kind of cool. Anyway, let's move on to, crafting. Because you got a glimpse of it. Anyway, okay, we're... Alright, so you got a crafting table. Now, this apparently, from what I heard from a YouTuber, is that this used to be a normal book icon, and now it's the type of a knowledge book. And, yeah, basically, you just have a crafting thing, and it can show you the recipe. Or it could be an easy way out of crafting really fast, which I'm not really a fan of. I just always wanted to see a book that shows you how to craft. So, yeah. But there's, like, a weird glitch in the thing. So, okay, so watch if I get a couple of sticks from, alright. If I get a couple of sticks, couple of string, place it in the crafting table, it shows me the recipe. But I have to, but I would like it if, like, it shows me the recipe and I can craft it myself. But since that's not how it's done, for if you want to craft it the quick way, then, yeah, you can do that and get a bow. Now, in the previous snapshot, it kind of had sort of a glitch, and it's having a glitch now, like... Oh, jeez. See? Now it glitched out again. All my stuff is there, and... Oh, jeez, there's the glitch again. And that started to change from white to red a couple of times. Hold on. Hold on, let me, stop it. Get out of here. Alright, so, now that that's done, it has a couple of glitchy moments. But yeah, if you just want it to show you the recipe, and then, like, later, if you don't know how to do it again, and you want to, like, just see the recipe one more time, then, yeah. Anyway, so, here's another thing. You can actually... There's a slot missing, and it's been replaced with save toolbars, and most of the stuff has been moved down to miscellaneous. But yeah, there's a save toolbar, so I can save one using Control 1. Oop, hold on. So yeah, I can save a toolbar with Control 1, and... It should... Hold on. I don't know why this isn't working. God damn it! Damn you! Damn it! Okay. Yeah, I'm doing Control 1. Hold on. Let me check my controls. Option controls. Let's see. Alright, let's see. Save toolbar activator. See. Ah, great. I'm stupid. C1. I have to do C1, and for if I want to load it, then I have to do X1. Why is it automatically set to that? Anyway, like, it will show that it's saved in that area, so when you scroll down... Then you can just throw in next toolbar that you want to save. And yeah. So just C2. And then delete all that. And then to restore it, I'm going to do X1. And then I can get rid of that. And if I want to do X2... Crap. If I do X2, I get the other half, so that's actually really useful, in my opinion. Anyway, but yeah. I wonder if you can do this in survival mode, but if... I don't know. Is it considered cheating if you are able to do it in survival mode? I don't know. Anyway, yeah, so that's basically it for all this... stuff, but there's one more thing I believe that is left that I got to show you. Look at you, green nitwit. All you do is do nothing in the game. I had expectations for you to be the best green returning villager ever, and now you're not. Mojang could have made you the cartographer, but no, you had to be worthless. How could you do this to me? Okay. Sorry about that. So yeah, we're just gonna go far away from that area so that way nobody gets harmed. And by far away, I mean just a couple of inches away, because that's all we can do. Why does this look like a pork chop to me? It's George, give me a sign. George, I'll always miss you. Okay, enough joking around. I do miss George, though. Anyway. Yeah, this will be a perfect spot. Alright. Summon. Minecraft. Illusion Illager. This is the new mob. So, we're gonna bring in my survival kit for, Give me a second. Alright, anyway, but yeah, we got the new mob Illusion Illager. He kind of has like a weird robe hat thing going on. But yeah, so I'm just gonna load up my survival toolbar, go into survival, and yeah, let's begin. There we go. Ah, jeez. Now, as you can see with the spectral arrow, he's cloned himself. But one is firing. Ah, jeez. You can't attack the clones. But there's one of him invisible. Haha, oh. That, but yeah. But yeah, now that we're in creative, this is what his clones look like. They move simultaneously. You can't hurt him, but you can see there's something. You can see, like, little light bubbles coming from them. And in the middle is the Illusion Illager. So, yeah. So he's always, like, somewhere in the middle. See that? In the middle. Alright. So, there he is, back as one. Let's quickly go back in. Shoot him again. There we go. And, yeah. See that? He's always in the middle. Oh, jeez. There we go. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Like, you can see a bit of bubbles. Like, you can see right there. The arrows are just coming out of thin air. Oh, come on. You've got to be kidding me. I know you're right there, you stupid bastard! There we go. You're not doing good by standing in one place. But yeah. You can kill them easily as long as you always attack for the middle. And like, because sometimes you'll be able to like find out where he is by just seeing the bubbles. But that's only some people. If you can't find the bubbles, just aim for the middle. It's kind of neat how they did it. But yeah, it would be nice if they could do that. But yeah, what's really useful is the spectral arrow. I thought it would keep a lock-on on the invisible one, or the real one, but no, it doesn't. Anyway, now that I look completely destroyed, I'm going to, get rid of the toolbar. I'm going to get rid of the toolbar. And yeah. So that's basically it. But yeah, that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed this, somewhat broken snapshot. Broken as in I am not organized and this is the first snapshot I've done. Hopefully you didn't leave yet, but, yeah, comment, like, and subscribe. We'll see you all next time. There will be another gameplay video coming out soon. And yeah, hopefully it will. And hopefully you guys will enjoy. So yeah. Comment, like, subscribe. I'm James of the New Squad 2, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye. Okay, I forgot to mention there's a narrator, as you can see right there, but I don't know how to activate it. Maybe it's not working in this snapshot, but I feel like it is. I just am stupid and don't know how to do it. Now, people said Control B, but I'm pressing Control B. I'm pressing Control and B at the same time, and nothing's working. Nope, nothing's working. I don't know how to get it to work, so... yeah. Anyway, that's the snapshot. Bye. What?